Hi, welcome to another episode of Tech Explained. This episode is going to be about seats, racing seats in a racing car. And obviously it's one of the first things that you need to do regarding safety. If you have a roll cage in a car, you absolutely have to use racing seats. If you use racing seats, you absolutely have to use racing belts. So at least a 4-point, but preferably a 6-point harness. It's very important if you buy a seat that you look at two basic things. That's the width of the seat. A good rule of thumb is if you sit in the seat with jeans or with normal clothing, you just put it static on the floor and you try to stand up, that the seat kind of still sticks with you, so it comes up a little bit. If you then sit in it with your racing overalls in it, then it's going to be a perfect snug fit. If you have a seat that's a bit too wide, then you're going to be moving around a lot and you're going to get bruised and all that stuff without even noticing it. Also, the car communicates a bit less with you because you feel a lot through your butt. So it's very important that you're really tight fitted into the car and you really feel the movement of the car around you. Second thing that's very important, often overlooked thing, these holes are of course for the part of the belt that goes over your shoulders. It's very important that this is the correct height, because if they are too low and your car crashes, the belts will actually tension and you can break your collarbones. I've seen it happen a few times. It's a very common injury in racing, and it's simply because these holes have to be higher than your shoulders. It's a very important thing. Next thing about seats is of course fitment. Everybody knows these things. They're the plates that you put on the side of the seat. They come in aluminum, they come in steel, and there's one big problem with them, and you cannot buy them to directly fit a racing seat into a BMW, because this distance is usually too short. I think it's at least 5 centimeters too short to fit in either an E30 or E36 or E46. So you're gonna either have to make a floor plate to make this fit, so that the length is not very correct. The other thing is, most of these seats are a lot narrower than factory seats, so the mounting points left and right of the seat in the car are also too far apart, so you usually need a bit more width over here. So these are great brackets. The only problem is that they don't straight fit into a BMW, and we're going to show you a couple solutions that we can offer for that problem. In this car we've mounted a seat. It's a kind of a cheap solution. It's a couple brackets that we sell, and you use them to position the seat more towards the transmission tunnel of the car, and it allows you to actually connect the smaller brackets to the bigger hole distance for the BMW. So that's one thing, and we'll show you a couple pictures in detail how that looks. These aluminum billet plates are a very nice solution to fit racing seats into a BMW chassis. They fit E36, E46 and E30, maybe some other chassis as well, but these are the ones that I tried them on. As I said, they're billet pieces. They've got M8 threads all over the place. They come with 4 10.9 bolts for each side. This side is the transmission side of the car, this side is the door side of the car, and as you can see, the one on the door is a lot wider, which means that you can position the seat towards the transmission tunnel, which centers you perfectly in front of the steering wheel, and it's also better for the, of course, the weight distribution in the car. And I'm quite happy that these are on the market now, and it's just a very good plug and play solution. Everybody who's ever fitted a racing seat to a BMW knows that it's not a short job. If you want to position it perfectly, usually you want to put them quite far to the back, and you want to, like I said, move them towards the transmission tunnel, and these things are a perfect solution for that. Here's a seat mounted in the car. I always like to put them a bit in an angle, so that if you brake, then the upper part of your legs is also going to help with stabilizing. If you put the seats up quite straight, then you're always pushing into the belts. I always like to have the bottom part, the part you actually sit on, to be tilted backwards a little bit, but that's a personal preference. My legs are quite long, so I also need to put them in an angle just to get to the car. The seat also should be quite close to the steering wheel. Your arm should make a 90 degree angle, because if you put them straight, then it's going to be very difficult. It's going to become very tiring to move the steering wheel around, especially on a drifting day where you steer a lot. And the belts are also installed in this car. As you can see, we have a harness bar over here in the back. That's the absolute best solution you can do regarding seats. It's not always possible, of course, because you need to have a full cage for it, but that's absolutely right. These sit exactly on the same level as the holes in the seat. So that's basically the best scenario you can have. It's also important that you look at the ones that the crotch straps, they should be not too far back. I think they should make a 10 degree angle or something like that. So make sure that before you put the holes and all the attachment points in the chassis, that you position the seat perfectly. It's actually one of the first things we do when we build a race car, is perfectly position the seat, because as you can see, the roll cage and everything, that's all made exactly to fit around the seat. So that's absolutely job number one, perfectly position the seat in the car before you do anything else. And then you make the correct FIA attachment points for these straps. And like I said, it's very preferable to have a harness bar, because that's just very good. What you absolutely should not do, what I see a lot with road cars, is that people put the shoulder straps all the way down to the original attachment points of the rear seat belts. That's very dangerous, because like I said, if you're in a crash, then they have the tendency to pull you down. Usually that won't happen in a small fender bender, but if you really crash like really hard, if a car spins in front of you, you haven't seen him, or a car just moves out of the way and you slam into it really hard, the worst case crash you can have on the racetrack, then you're gonna pull a lot of G's. And it's very important that these belts will simply hold you in your place and not push you down in your seat, because like I said, you'll break your collarbones just like that. I've seen it happen a few times, so that's very important. So always bear in mind to get the right size of the seat. Should not be too narrow, it should really stick to you if you sit in it with normal clothes. Make sure that the position for the shoulder straps is correct, it's not too low, and spend a lot of time positioning the seat in the car, making sure that it's just right, because that's basically the first thing you do when you build a car, and everything else is built around it. I hope you enjoyed watching, and subscribe to our channel, and if you have any questions, you can post them on info@einzel.nl.